and it asks me, can I kick it? Word. Can I kick it? Yes, you can.
Like a tribe does. Before this, did you really know what I was? Comprehend to the track force. Why? Because getting mentions on the.
I failed. I was not good enough to make the varsity basketball team. I got cut. Do not pity me. Pity is reserved for abused puppies who have no control over the situation. I had complete control over my situation and still allowed myself to come up short. I would like to say my effort was undeserving of being cut, but this is not true. Yet this is not to say I did not work hard and give my all. In my first lecture, I detailed the countless hours of practice shooting, dribbling, and scrimmaging put in to give myself the best opportunity to make the varsity team, to achieve my goal. If added up, days of time was spent driving places to play basketball. The number of vegetables I eat haunts me. My last month before tryouts was dedicated solely to school and basketball, and if school was not mandatory, you would not have found me there. I stand by these claims. They are not hyperbole. I have never worked harder for something in my life. There is unshakable pride surrounding the effort and work I committed myself to. However, in the end, the verdict from the varsity coach proved not only whether I made the team, but whether or not I worked hard enough. I did not make the team, and therefore did not work hard enough. Sports are an unbiased and continuous judgment of players. Basketball does not care who you are, how big you are, how hard you work, how much talent you have, or what kind of person you are. These things can be advantageous, but when a person steps on the court, all that matters is their play. In many ways, basketball is a microcosm of the real world. Both are unfair, but the outcome of any situation reflects reality. You can put yourself in a situation to succeed, but so is everyone else. Competition drives the world forward, but leaves the losers in the dust. Everyone wants to succeed, but on the basketball team, or in searching for a job, there is not room for everyone. Being cut from the basketball team exposed me to reality. Having lived a very sheltered and comfortable life, I have never needed anything or thought that something I desired was far from my grasp. This luxury allowed me to grow up completely unexposed to the heartless struggle and competition that I assume is real life. Always you are told that if you work hard, you can do, be, have, whatever you want. So while putting in the work, hard work, I expected to make the team. How could I not? Never had I worked so hard for anything in my life, and still had achieved everything that I sought. While toiling along, putting in work, other players who felt they had a spot waiting for them on the team sat back and waited for the season. All the elements of a beautiful underdog victory set up the disregarded player to edge out the arrogant jock. Yet tryouts came, and my immediate core performance is diminished by their strong play bolstered with confidence. Just like that, my effort and dedication mean nothing. Some might say that it is unfair, but would it be fair to cut someone with superior play? They prepared differently than me, a lazy and unmotivated approach that led them to success. Preparing to attain ambitions is only preparing. Whilst influence may sway the outcome, goals are reached through performance, not preparation. Basketball will forever be a part of my life as I catch the lesson it passes me. After graduating college, I will not be blindsided when the hard-earned degree does not get me the job I want, or be confused while in the midst of agonizing work, I'm still failing to pay off my bills. I know it means I am working hard, but not enough. Basketball taught me to put my head down and work harder.
Can I kick it to all the people who can quest like a tribe does? Before this, did you really know what I was? Comprehend to the track force, why? Cause getting mentions on the tip of the vibe was rock and roll to the beat of the funk fuzz.